to show you how to get this festival Coachella-ish, not really inspired makeup tutorial. I've been seeing just a crap ton of festival related things online. I live in Toronto, so we don't have any festivals yet, and it's cold and rainy still. But feeling the envy, and I wish I was at Coachella. So here's a festival inspired look that doesn't appropriate anyone's culture. Fantastic, get on that. So, because Coachella, it's a thing. So, don't appropriate anyone's culture. Have fun at festivals. Cover your face in glitter or whatever you want to cover your face in. And I hope you guys really enjoyed this tutorial. I know I was away for a little bit. My semester ended a couple days ago, so I'm back. I'm feeling it. Everything good is happening. And hopefully I'll be posting some more videos soon. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. I hope you guys really enjoyed this look. And if you want to see how I did it, just keep on watching. Okay, so I've already moisturized beforehand, and now I'm going to start off with our primer. I'm using the Benefit Professional Primer. I figure it's going to be hot and sweaty for festivals. Just want to stay matte. So this is the first primer that I'm going to use. I'm going to focus this mostly along my T-zone and along my forehead, and the places I generally get oiliest the fastest. I'm just going to take this up my forehead. And then just kind of use the rest kind of along the rest of my face. Second primer that I'm going to use is the Tarte Brighter Days Moisturizer / Primer. I don't know entirely, but it's likely makeup uses it. So I feel like if she uses it, I should use it. If she wore army pants and flip-flops, I'd go buy army pants and flip-flops. Not mean. That was a Mean Girls reference, and I'm gonna hope that everyone got it. Or else, go away. Actually, I'm joking, I don't have any viewers, so don't leave. Just gonna take this everywhere else. I just like the way that this looks. It gives like a nice kind of glowy look to the skin. And I mean, I kind of want to stay matte in the places I get oiliest, but I think for like the festival season, I do want to do kind of like a glowier face. So to do that, what I'm taking is the Naked Skin, what is this? One and Done Complexion Primer, Hybrid Complexion Primer. Wow, Perfector. I can't speak, but it's fucking awesome. And it's got SPF 20 in it. So I think that just for festivals in general, I think that like anything with SPF, I think it's a good idea. And I'm going to do about 4 pumps of this on my hand. It's a pretty light coverage foundation, so I do like to use a bit more of it. I'm all over the place today, but I'm just going to start applying this with a brush. I feel like it looks really orange in this light. Also, I'm using the shade Light, I believe. Yeah. Which I believe is the lightest shade that they have. Okay, and then now I actually like to add a second foundation just along my T-zone. I'm gonna add my NYX Total Control Drop Foundation. I'm just gonna add a little bit of this where I get oiliest. It is quite a bit more of a fuller coverage, but it's really lightweight and it's really mattifying, so I need that, because you can probably fry an egg on my face by the end of the day. Especially after a festival, your girl gets oily, so. I'm just going to add a little bit of this. I'm going to add this along my forehead. And like the center of my face. It is also a little bit lighter than the foundation I'm wearing, so it's just going to be a little bit more brightening. That looks... And you're ready to go! So, let's just blend this out with the Beauty Blender once again. So, I'm running really low on my Kat Von D Locket Concealer Cream. Wow, that was terrible. But I'm running out of it, so I'm going back into the Naked Skin Weightless Complete Coverage Concealer. TBT to when everyone lost their shit over this, but it's still really good. So, I'm using what I can of the Kat Von D one, whatever I can literally scrape out of it, and then gonna use that one as well. This one's super brightening, so we can just take this along more to the center of the face and like closest to the under eyes. Ah, there we go. She's starting to die out. Oh no. Oh no. That's not good. That's not good. Okay, and I'm also just gonna take a little bit on my eyelids. Just as a primer, and also just to brighten my eyelids, just so they're not darker than the rest of my face. And now I'm going to take that Urban Decay concealer. Wow, this one's basically dying too. Haley, get on top of your shit. Get some new concealer. Okay. Now you're done. This is cute. This is a cute look. So just continue to blend this in with your beauty blender. So we are blended, now let's go set that. My go-to setting powder is always the Kat Von D Locket Translucent Setting Powder. It's my everything. It's fucking awesome. It's so good. As you can tell, I love Kat Von D. Everything she does and everything she puts out is fire. It's so good. I'm kind of obsessed. So just taking another damp beauty sponge. Alright, so my apologies, my camera decided to just not be a camera anymore and decided to stop filming when I was filming. But regardless, probably what you missed was that I baked basically the entirety of my face. I baked my under eyes, I baked basically along my entire nose, smile lines, and then it's like a general dusting of the translucent powder along the rest of my face. So, now I'm going to start drawing in my brows. As you can tell, one, I have grandpa eyebrows, and I have still little sparse bits of blonde in the ends because I bleached my eyebrows a little while ago, and I'm growing them out. So I'm doing that, and also because it's festival, and I just think it should be like glowy and natural-ish-esque, not really, but I wanted to do some like fluffy brows. So I've been changing up my brow routine on and off, and I've discovered the NYX Eyebrow Powder Pencil. It's changed my brow game. I'm obsessed with it. It's a pencil, but it looks fluffy like a powder. It's fantastic. So I'm gonna start running this through my brows and then kind of spoolie my way through to kind of fix any harsh lines. So I have the brows drawn in now, and now to finish them, what I like to take is my NYX, just like a tinted brow mascara. It's in the shade Espresso. I just like to use this one to kind of still kind of give my brows even more of a fluffy look and to add some more dimension, but also Because my little blonde edges kind of stick through the little ends of my what used to be bleached brows. They kind of still like to show themselves. So now they're covered up. To do the face, what I like to do to knock off the translucent powders, I like to take the NYX No Filter, this foundation finishing powder. I'm in the shade 3 Ivory. I don't even know if it's the right shade. It might be a little dark, but I don't know. I mean, it's what they had in stock, and I just needed something. So that's what I'm using. So I'm just going to use like a little synthetic brush. It's a little like duo fiber brush, but it's just by MAC. It's the 180, I think. Like, the numbers are kind of wearing off, so I think it's a 180. I could be wrong, though. I, like, used to work at MAC, but I, like, don't remember all the brushes and whatnot. And then now what I'm taking is just, like, a tulip brush by Morphe. A lot of the brushes that I'm using, if I don't say the name or number, they're probably just, like, these vegan Morphe brushes. The vegan collection by Morphe doesn't have names or numbers. It's just the vegan set, so this is one of them. And for my contour and everything, I love to use my Kat Von D Shade and Light. So I'm taking just this, wow, I'm taking this guy right here to highlight with. And I'm just taking this under my eyes. I kind of like to just take the shade along like the center of my face, just to kind of further brighten. And now, again, from that vegan Morphe collection, it's just, I guess, a foundation brush or a powder brush or a bronzer brush, I don't know, but it looks like this. It's kind of tapered-ish, not mean, and dirty, sorry. But to contour, I actually kind of like to take a mix of all three of these contour shades. I use them for different things. I kind of use the middle shade, it's a little warmer, so I like to do that as like an all-around bronze, more so using the cool tone shade to contour and to contour my nose, just because I feel like my nose contour, I like it to be a little bit more subtle, because one, I'm Armenian and I've got a huge nose, so I need to contour it, but I'm also like not the greatest at nose contouring, so I kind of like to do it a little bit subtly, so if I fuck it up, no one's going to be like, whoa girl, what's that nose? So, and then the last shade, it's more so if I really want to do like a deeper contour, and I take that just in like the hollows of my cheekbones, just kind of like deepen it a little bit. So, starting off with that middle shade, just kind of brushing it around, just to give a little bit of warmth to the face. Okay, so now taking that cooler tone. I'm just gonna take a little bit of that deeper shade. Just some hollows. And now I'm just taking a smaller brush. This is actually by, like, I don't know how to say it, Bdellium Tools. It's the 780 brush. It's just a small detail brush. I like to take this to just to contour my nose down. Now that we have our face on, actually, to kind of finish it, I like to, I'm gonna add a little bit of a highlight. I figure because I'm already doing glitter, I'm not gonna like do a crazy highlight. And actually, I like totally strayed from liquid and cream highlights for the longest time. But again, I like work at NYX. So in my gratis, I got the NYX Away We Glow liquid highlighter, and I got it in the shade Crystal Glare, and I'm fucking in love with it. It's so pretty. And I realized the trick that I at least like to do with liquid and cream highlights is I like to just pat it in with my fingers instead of using a brush. I just find that also because I use so much powder on my face, I kind of strayed away just because I was like, ah, like liquid and powder, that's terrifying, but I've kind of found a way, at least for now. So I'm going to be just applying this directly to where I'd highlight and then just patting it in. This I find also just gives a little bit more of a natural glow. Kind of more so like a wet look rather than like a shimmer highlight. that like can be seen from space, which typically is what I go for. There we go. So, just to set it, I'm going to take a little bit of a powder highlight. I'm going to be taking the Becca Moonstone highlight. It is just the little mini sample one of it, but I just think it's so cute, and I do kind of just want to set it a little bit. I'm taking a little MAC 224 brush and just kind of lightly sweeping it over top of it. I'm not really packing it on. I just kind of want it to set. Taking it along the forehead. There we go. So that's all we're gonna be doing for highlighting, that I promise, that's it. Okay, so now like for the lids, what I'm gonna be taking, I just grabbed my Too Faced Peach palette. So I've already set my eyes earlier on with that translucent powder. So what I'm thinking of doing is really just running some neutral shades throughout my crease and just kind of lightly, at least add something to the eye so it's not naked. I think I'm gonna blend the two shades, Summer Yum and Puree. They're just, there we go. They're just down here. I'm terrible at that. But I'm gonna just mix those two shades really subtly along like my crease. I kind of just going a little bit messy with it though, just more so it's like a light wash of color. And to do that, I'm taking my Morphe M441 brush. This is one of my favorite Morphe brushes. It's so fluffy. Okay, so I'm just gonna start blending this through the crease. Actually, you know what? Totally changing my mind. I think I want to do a cut crease. Yeah, see, juices are flowing. I think I'm gonna do a cut crease. I like these colors, so I'm gonna stick with all of this. But I think I just wanna add, I think I just needed to add something. Yeah, I think a cut crease is where we're going. So I'm gonna just keep deepening this up for a little bit, just so I can, just so it can be nice and defined when I cut the crease. And along with this, I'm just continuing to kind of drag that shadow outwards. Kind of in like a swooping, kind of just a little out. So I mean, it's a little bit messy, but as we do the cut crease, we can clean it up quite a bit more. So I'm just gonna go back and take another concealer and just cut the crease with a small detail brush. So again, I'm just going in with that same kind of like really frayed detail brush. I use this brush for everything. Again, I have no idea where I got it from. I don't know where my mom got it from, because I definitely stole it from her, from where she kept all her makeup back when I lived at home. And I mean, mom, if you know where you got this brush, please tell me, because it's awesome. So I'm just going to go in with that concealer, and I'm just going to start cutting the crease. I do like to bring the crease a little bit higher than my actual natural crease, just so I can kind of open my eyes up even more. It just gives the illusion that your eyes are just a little bit bigger. So I think I'm going to take the shade Luscious. It's just this shade right there. And honestly, at least to kind of start off, I like to take shimmer shades actually just straight onto my finger. I think that it just looks really pretty. I think the warmth of your finger kind of grabs onto the product really nicely. I kind of thought that the shade that I was already using was a little bit too warm for me, at least for all over. So what I'm thinking about using actually is my MAC Vanilla Pigment. It's been a minute since I grabbed this. I used to be obsessed with it like years ago. So I am just gonna start slowly packing this on. Again, I'm actually gonna continue to start with my finger. It's a little bit harder because it's a loose pigment, but I'll use my finger and then I'll kind of clean it up with a brush. Okay, so I've now got both eyes on of that, like, finally decided on cut crease. So now we're moving on to lashes. So I'm just going to be taking my Benefit Roller Lash Mascara. It's like my all-time favorite mascara. All I can find right now is my mini size one, so that's what we're using. And we're also going to be taking my, I'm going to be taking my Velour Lashes. I'm using, they're in the style Fluffin Dolled Up. I'm gonna try to show them. They're like, they've been well loved, but they're still going on strong. So this is what the style looks like. So they're just like pretty thick, especially because I'm not doing a liner. I just wanted like a nice thick lash to at least give some kind of definition and volume. So I'm gonna be grabbing my lash curler. Also, unfortunately, grabbing my stinky, nasty, duo glue. It's so bad. But I don't want to pay $1 million in shipping to get other glue, and that's the only glue that's not $1 million. So, broke art student problems, sticking with duo glue for now, and I'm just gonna plug my nose. It's fine. So, I'm gonna start curling my lashes, and I'm gonna start putting some mascara on. So I really just want a light layer of it, just enough to make sure all the lashes are coated in this, in the black mascara, just so my natural lashes don't peek through when I'm after I put my false ones on. Okay, so that's on. I'm just gonna start getting the glue on my fake lashes. Okay, so the lashes are on my eyes. They're good. The lash glue is kind of stinky, but it's fine. Yeah, it's pretty stinky, but it's whatever. I'm gonna actually go back in with my mascara and just kind of go in and kind of merge my real and the fake lashes. I don't wanna add too much product because obviously you shouldn't really be putting too much product on your false lashes if you want them to last longer. And okay, so the lashes are done. I'm not really gonna add anything to the lower lash line just yet, just because I'm not entirely too sure what I'm doing with the glitter. So I'll do the glitter stuff and then we'll go back in with the lower lash line. So to do with the glitter, what I'm gonna use is, I'll grab it. Okay, I realized as I was looking at the glitter I initially said I would use, I actually have something else that I think would look nice with it. So originally the glitter I grabbed was my Lit Cosmetics glitter, and I grabbed it in the, it's in the shade Tinseltown. So it is this, I'm gonna try to like focus it on this so you can kind of see. It's so messy, it's like a couple years old, but it's not even closing properly. But I'm gonna kind of zoom you in to kind of see what this looks like. Focus? Yeah, so it's kind of this like holographic reflective silver glitter. And also what I'm gonna be using with this is my NYX Face and Body Glitter. This is in the shade Crystal, or the color Crystal, I don't know. But it looks like this, so really similar, but it's a little bit chunkier. The pieces of glitter are just a little bit bigger. So I think the mix of the two of these, there we go. I think the mix of the two of them would look really pretty. So, got a shit ton of the primer on the back of my head. And what I'm thinking of doing is literally just kind of like a long thing of glitter. So, I'm gonna just start kind of patting this on where I think I'm gonna put the glitter on. I need enough. I'm like unsure. I never really used the glitter primer. I know people love it. I honestly, majority of the time, use the mixing medium. I just find it so comfortable. So, yeah, so just kind of taking that downwards. And I believe I'm gonna start with the Lit Cosmetics glitter. And I'm just gonna take to do this is a Morphe M411 brush. It's just like a smaller kind of blending brush, but because I just wanna grab quite a bit of this glitter, it works nicely, I think. Oh yeah, there we go. So that's where we're gonna place that. And we're kind of just letting it kind of taper down. Now I'm going to be kind of piling on that NYX glitter. I'm trying to just open it up. Because the little sifter thing. It's for the weak-hearted. People who need a little bit of glitter. That's not me, boo. That's not me. So I already got a fuck ton of glitter all over myself and all over the couch. It's cool, it's fine. So we're just gonna now kind of pile this on top. Yeah, there we go. Just to add a little kind of extra dimension to it. I think I'm actually gonna put some mascara on my lower lashes just to kind of add a little bit more of a barrier. Because I know that the glitter is sticking to my lower lashes. So this will at least kind of brush them out and kind of prevent that. So just also if you like can build up your lower lashes as much as you can, just because I think that it'll look really nice and they'll really kind of get to stand out from that glitter. There we go. So I'm going to zoom you guys in just a little bit more so you can kind of see that. Okay, so that's the first eye. Gonna go ahead and start on that second eye. Doing the exact same thing, just patting that glitter primer all the way down. Honestly, I kind of want to bring it even lower. So I might... I'm gonna do that a little bit. I'm gonna add a little bit more dark lips. There we go. It just needed that extra little bit. I just added a little bit more. I want it to be like a full, like long, dramatic tear. I was thinking of even taking it like down my neck, but I was like, maybe that's a little much. I don't know, but I think it looks sick anyway. So sorry. Wow. Before I let like the primer like literally dry, I should probably finish that. Okay. So basically done with the eyes and with the face. I just have to add a lip now. I've decided. So, what I'm doing is I'm going to take a nude lip and then I'm going to cover it in glitter because then at least it'll, and you can just focus on the glitter instead of it being like a super bold lip and then glitter. Where I think we're going to use the less chunky glitter, we'll use the Lit Cosmetics glitter. Okay, I'm laying a tissue down because as if to prevent, I should have done this the first time around. But regardless, the lip that I'm using today, I'm using the Sandstorm Liquid Suede by NYX. Yeah, I know, I have the mini one. I can't find my full size one, so again, I'm using the mini. But it's whatever, it's the same color, it's the same product, it's whatever. So, I am gonna just apply this. Okay, gonna go back in with that glitter primer. Just gonna add a little bit of it. I'm gonna be adding the glitter just kind of to the center of the lips, I think. So, I know that the suede is still kind of drying. Ooh, I'm getting glitter everywhere. Okay. I'm just gonna pat this on like the center of the lips. So the glitter primer's on. Going back in with that Morphe M411 brush and just grabbing that same Tinseltown glitter by Lit. The look is complete. To finish this, all we're gonna grab is some setting spray. The setting spray that I like to use is, right now at least, is the NYX Matte Finish setting spray. So I'm just gonna go ahead and douse myself in this. You are gonna be at a festival, you want this shit to last! So, it's all good. This is the final look. I hope that you enjoy it. This is my face, this is the final look, and I can taste glitter. It's fabulous. I feel like I embody Coachella now. I'm living for it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this look. Thanks for sticking by, because this is gonna be a long video. I'm like watching the timer and it's long. Thank you for sticking by me and all my technical difficulties and the fact that I hadn't uploaded for a while because school. But yeah, I hope to see you guys back really soon. Please just don't forget to like and subscribe. I'd really appreciate that, and I hope to see you guys again soon. Thanks so much, guys.